Our sanctuary flowers are given to the honor and glory of God and in honor of Courtney Jameson's birthday by Jamie and Kim. First off, you'll find your attendance books at the end of each row. If you please take a second to chime in so we can keep records of who all was here. We're very excited to have Vanessa Kersting with us this morning. We're looking forward to her presentation of her songwriting and singing gifts. A love offering will be taken up to show our appreciation and thanks for her. Afterwards, our fifth Sunday potluck luncheon will be directly following service. Everybody's invited to attend, and this one's going to be extra special because we're giving Blanche Cornsworthy lots of hugs and prayers to take with her to Texas. She's leaving this week to go stay with Anne and her husband Daryl so they can help her as she continues recovering. The youth are going to be having a water night from 5:30 to 7 this evening, so you wear something that you feel like you can get wet in. It's going to be fun. We've got bubbles and stuff. Wednesday night, food pantry is going to be, no, that's Wednesday morning. Food pantry is from 9 to 10. And then Wednesday night, the choir's going to get back to business and practice at 5:30 in the choir room. Youth is going to meet at 6 o'clock for prep night Tuesday. Next Sunday is our long-awaited church cookout and water slide afternoon. We'll take a break from all the fun and feasting later in the day to have our book bag blessing. So be sure you have your book bags with you. A sign-up sheet is on the table in the fellowship hall, and we do ask that you take time to let us know if you're planning on participating so that we have enough food for everybody. Tuesday, August 8th is voting day. For Marvin, this means that our gym and activity center will be closed from Monday, August 7th through Wednesday morning. So you won't be able to get in on those days. We have more events and happenings coming up, so be sure to read your bulletin and let somebody know if you have any questions. Are there any other announcements that need to be made? All right, if we don't have any, then let us quiet our hearts as we prepare for worship. And may the Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Thank you. chapter 5. We pray that the music we make or the songs that we sing are always from our hearts to yours. We pray that as we sing songs, hymns, and spiritual songs, that we dedicate each melody to you. We pray that we always give you thanks for all things, and we thank you for the talents that you've given us, and we choose to give them back to you by using them to glorify your name. And it is in Jesus' name that we pray. Amen. Opening hymn is on page 158. Come, Christians, join us sing. Vanessa has placed in a number of charts, including Today's Christian Music Top 100 Songs for 2015, 2019, 2020, 2021, and 2022. We have a star among us, you guys. Vanessa has also placed in the Christian Music Top 100 Artists for 2015 and the 50 Artists of 2021 and 2022. And I just found out that Vanessa has been nominated for the People's Choice Awards in Australia. Congratulations, Vanessa. Additionally, her 8 singles released to radio landed in the Christian Music Top 30, along with some of today's popular artists, which are two of my favorites, for King & Country, Rebecca St. James, and Lauren Drabel, for a combined total of 98 weeks over the last 8 years. These singles include Hold the Stars, which held in the top 100 for 22 weeks, Here, All Along, Included, God is Good, My Good Shepherd, Faithful, which is her new single, held in the top 30s for 6 weeks, and Love Story for 4 weeks. Vanessa has toured throughout Australia and all over the world with the themes of love and hope in her music. Vanessa is passionate to see the truth of the gospel permeate deep into people's souls and uses this as a basis every time she sings and speaks. We'll see her in just a few minutes.
Now we invite our ushers to come forward that we may worship God with God's tithes and our offerings. And as we tithe, I want to let you know that the metal plates are, of course, for our regular church tithes, but we have baskets special for Vanessa for love offerings. And so, just so you know where your money's going. Gracious Lord, in so many ways you have blessed us. As we return to you a part of that blessing, Lord, we ask that you multiply it, touch it, lift it up in your service for your glory and us in your faith. In Christ's holy name, amen. Confession of the Christian faith.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. The third day he arose from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sits at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Thank you. Please do be seated. We unite our hearts and thoughts of prayer. Specifically, I want to lift up Leonard Blanton and Susan and family. Leonard's had a rough week. He's been in and out, or he's still in ICU, but he's been on and off the respirator, currently off and trying to hold his own. Just keep that family, and he specifically, in your thoughts. We're going to pray for Blanche later on at our meal, but we've got a special prayer for you. Anything else that anybody wants to pray about? Yes, sir. For Diane?
What were you going to say? You were first.
Oh, I was just going to give an update on Jeremy.
Yes, please.
Radiation treatments, 29 to go. He is doing wonderfully.
Abigail comes on tomorrow and flies on from Spain.
From Spain. Look forward to her stories. Anybody else? We're so blessed, musically talented, and we're blessed to have Vanessa with us. It's going to give us our message in the form of song as she shares with us. But what an opportunity it is to gather. This past week, I saw a remarkable thing. From 7 a.m. till nearly 8 p.m., we had folks on our roofs just hammering and working away all week long. I was thinking, if I got up there, I'd last about 30 minutes. Somebody had to drag me to the ER. Some of these folks are pastors, too, in their own tradition, but I wanted to name them out loud because I think these are some special people, and I'm grateful that we've got a new group. But Mario Valderas Jr., Harold Camarena, Mateo Juan Domingo, Samuel Emilino Ramos, Mateo Gomez, Rogelio Manuel, Ibran Zarita, Juan and Francisco Hugo. So these are some of the folks working with Dave Batista that put our roof on, and I am grateful that we've got it, and I appreciate our trustees and our stewards that helped to get all that together. It's hot out there, folks, and it's going to get even hotter this week. So let's take care of one another, and let's pray for one another. And as we pray, the Lord be with you. Gracious God, for a few moments, we pause and we give you thanks. Thank you for a cool and a safe place to gather as we look for your holy touch, for your nurturing, Lord, for your inspiration for tomorrow. Lord, I pray your blessings be with Vanessa as she brings through the power of your Holy Spirit your message and song. Lord, bless us in our hearts as we go this week, that when people look to us, they may see you and they may know you in their lives as well. Lord, we give you thanks as we remember as Christ taught us to pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever and ever and ever.
Church family, let's give a warm welcome to Vanessa Kersting.
Good morning, everyone. Who dwells on high. He plunged into outer darkness to bring the light of life. Wake up and see amazing grace in flesh, the Father known, to share with us within our reach the life that is His own. O Spirit, grant with open face that we this man would see and know his heart and soul and mind, and share his victory. Inspire our empty hearts to run to this vicarious one, and give us fellowship with him, the Father's one true Son. And give us fellowship with him, the Father's one true Son.
You know, that's my prayer for us this morning, that the Spirit will unveil our eyes so that we can see Jesus, so that we can see all that has been accomplished in and through here, and how much we are loved. And my prayer is also that we know that love right to the depth of the core of our being, and that we know that when we look at the face of Jesus, we are looking at the face of the Father as well. So that's my prayer for us this morning. Colossians chapter 1 talks about the fact that Christ is the one who holds all things, and he is the one who sustains all things. So this song that I want to share next is called Somewhere.
You hold all things together, you're the center of it all. You embraced all things forever, you're the center of it all. Beautiful, our minds can comprehend.
You in his hands. Nothing left
can't take a step, but you give me rest. When weariness is spreading to the reaches of my soul, your love makes me whole. You know everything I'm needing, you're the air that I am breathing, my good shepherd. My good shepherd, you're the comfort to my fear. Yeah, I know you're always here. My good shepherd, my good shepherd knows my need. Spirits fire.
So last night, a friend was talking to me about watching the TV show The Chosen. Has anyone seen The Chosen?
Yes.
Yeah, I have never watched it until last night. But I wanted to share a verse with you that was kind of the main kind of verse through the episode last night. It goes, "But now this is what the Lord, your Creator, says, O Jacob, and he who formed you, O Israel, do not fear, but I have redeemed you. I have called you by name. You are mine." And I just, it keeps going. It goes, "When you pass through the waters, I will be with you. And through the rivers, they will not overwhelm you. When you walk through the fire, you will not be scorched, nor will the flame burn you." Kind of just another cool reminder of that promise of America that, you know, no matter what we're facing, we have the Creator and sustainer of all things holding us together. Have you guys heard the song "I Want to Know What Love Is"? Yeah, it's kind of an older song by Foreigner. Yeah. Which I am, I'm a foreigner, right? but earlier this year, I was kind of trying to find some songs that I could play at a cafe that I was playing at, and I was just, I picked out this one because it's kind of cool. But when I was reading through the lyrics, it kind of really took on a whole new level of wellness for me. I want to read it to you, right? It goes, "This mountain I must climb feels like the world upon my shoulders. Through the clouds I see love shine. It keeps me warm as the life grows colder." Which kind of ties us back to that verse of, you know, God is with us, even when we feel like the world's on our shoulders. Then it goes, "In my life there's been heartache and pain. I don't know if I can face it again." Have you ever been there? Have you ever been in that place where life is just so hard, you're just like, "I don't know if I can do this," right? And then it goes, "I can't stop now. I've traveled so far to change this lonely life." And it goes, "I want to know what love is. I want you to show me. I want to feel what love is. I know you can show me." Those four lines, that's like the cry of every human heart, right? "I want to know what love is. Please show me what love is." You know, the next bit, this is my favorite bit. It goes, "Gotta take a little time to look around me. I've got nowhere left to hide. Looks like love has finally found me." You know, in the middle of our pain and this and brokenness, love has come and found us. That cry of our hearts, "I want to know what love is. Please just show me what love is," has been met in Jesus. Jesus has come into the midst of our pain, and he lifts our face and looks us in the eye and says, "You are mine." You know, there has never been a moment where you have not been loved. You know, love has come into the midst of everything and found us. And that's why I'm loving this song right now, because it just captures that cry, but also the answer. Love has come and found us. So this morning I'm going to go a little risque and sing "Foreigner." How's that sound? Feel free to join in if you would like. Little time to look around me.
case I need it when I'm older. In my life, there's been heartache and pain. I don't know if I can face it again. Can't stop now, I've traveled so far to change this. Always there for us, no matter where we are, no matter what we're going through.
And Jesus says to us, in the middle of our mess and chaos, he says, let me love you. You know, there's the verse that says, love one another as I have loved you. Often we focus on that first part of the verse, right? Love one another. It's an important thing to do, right? You've got to love each other. But the other part is just as important, as I have loved you. You know, loved. Before we ever knew how to say any kind of prayer, love. Right? So the response to that song, I want to know what love is. Jesus says, let me love you. The chaos can make it hard to hear sometimes. But he goes, come, come and sit with me. Come and rest a while and let me show you what love is. So as I sing this next song, I want to just encourage and invite you just to kind of let him love you and just reveal to you more the depth of that love that he has for you. Then we've got some yummy food coming up. I picked the right week to come, right? Yeah. Food is always good. If there's two things that I want for you to walk away with today, the first thing is, oh, hang on, maybe we need to go three. I like to say that I'm Australian. Aussies kind of count, right? Okay, so a couple of things that I want for you to take away. The first is God is good. And the Father, Son, and Spirit, when everything is going to chaos, that's where we can plant our feet on the goodness and faithfulness of God. Right? The promise of Emmanuel is with us always. And lastly, you are loved more than you can possibly dream. You know, sometimes it feels like we're on our own, but that's not the promise of Emmanuel. Emmanuel is that we will never be left or forsaken. We will never be left on our own. You know? We are loved more than we can dream. We are beloved sons and daughters of the Father, and nothing is ever going to change that. So this last song is just a little bit of a summary of those things. It's called You Are Loved.
You are loved more than you can dream. You are loved more than anything. Better than anything you've seen. Rather than all imagining. Yes, it's true.
Of your United Methodist hymnal.
has an honor. It's written by Kurt Kaiser in 1969, and he wrote it for a youth camp. But since then, this song has taken on a life all its own, and it is now across the world. It's across denominations, and as you can see, it's in our hymnal as well. Kaiser once said, "I am always amazed how the Lord can take a little song and use it to reach so many people." Vanessa, you have blessed our hearts today, and by your talent and your gift of song, and our prayer is that you will continue to use your music to pass it on. 572. We'll sing the first and last verse.
Let's stand, please.
Please stand.
Give you peace. Let all God's children say,
Amen.